As you've heard, Maine nurse Casey Hickox is vowing to defy a state order to remain quarantined at home. She said, okay, joining us to discuss all of this is Casey Hickox attorney, Norman's you here.
Good morning.
What is Casey's plan today?
First, I want to say in the opening, there is no court with her boyfriend. And if they try to arrest her, that would be illegal. If they get the court order, tend to fly up to Maine and to challenge it.
Is she planning to go to work today?
Well,
state troopers around her house.
State troopers
right
yesterday,
now.
But at this point, and they try to put handcuffs on her. Scream in a court of law, not out on the streets in Maine.
Sanjay, before I bring you in, I want to read the governor of Maine's statement about all of this. He has said, Governor Paul LePage, this individual, meaning Casey Hickox, has stated publicly she will not abide by the protocols. We are exploring all of our options for protecting the health and well-being of the healthcare worker, anyone who comes into contact with her, the Fort Kent community, and all of Maine. He says he's protecting the public health. What's your response? Mr. Siegel.
Just to tell us that as long as she doesn't have the symptoms.
How do we end this standoff?
Well, you know, I mean, I'm sure the Doctors Without Borders recommend, you know, I looked at their guidance. I think this is 40 years now of data. And they say that how you start to see evidence here in the United States even, right, Mr.
It made New Yorkers nervous.
If the question is, does it make people nervous, I think it's a fair question, scared or nervous. Then we should say that
if there's a decision based, you have to follow the Constitution and the law. We're a nation of the rule of law, and to the governor in Maine, make sure you follow.
The media is abuzz with this topic, as you know, and people are on both sides of the fence. Let me read to you some of the tweets that have been sent in to CNN. The first one is in favor of Casey Hickox. This is from Beth Ann David. Then there's this other strain that you hear is a refrain out there, which says 21 days. That's a little sacrifice to keep the public, to quell the public's anxiety.
It's going to infringe on someone's liberty interest even for a minute, let alone for 21.
Interesting thing is that the slippery slope, taking care of 4 patients successfully, they've all X now. Are you going to quarantine the doctors at Emory? Are you going to quarantine the doctors at NIH, including Dr. Fauci, who helped take care of
an example,
yes.
If we go to court next week, according to this protocol, Casey can't even come to court. Because it will be in the public.
Yes, but of course, the argument is that the patients who cared for Thomas Duncan in Dallas healthcare workers did become infected, and that Dr. Craig Spencer, who was traveling around New York, who at first was showing no symptoms, then did develop symptoms and did in fact contract Ebola. So there's always an example of either side.
But just to be close, because Casey Hickox is like the nurse Duncan.
Correct.
And those nurses, as far as we know, did not transmit the virus to anybody.
Right.
Yes. The point is that many people feel 21 days is not that big of a sacrifice to quell the anxiety.
But then that's sacrificing ourselves to medical ignorance. They'd be tough guys, but they're pandering in a political sense. This kind of debate. Anyone quarantine the politician?
This morning, you say that a decision will be made when you have a conference call with your client, Casey Hickox. What are you going to recommend to her?
As soon as you let me off the set.
That's in 15 minutes.
Right.
What are you going to say?
A client's decision, and you have to do that because it's her life. All I can be, as I learned when I was in Mississippi in the 60s, I am the technician. I am not the decision.
Thanks so much for taking time for us. We will look forward to hearing what happens after that conference
call.
Follow
his advice.
Sanjay, we always do. We always
no
do.
No
Listen to Sanjay's advice. Thanks so much. Michaela, what else do you have?
And we'll let